Beloved, once again, we thank God that you've joined us this morning, and God is trying to put fire into your spirit so you can move with strength, with grace, and that you can overcome the enemies in your path. God wants to redefine your spiritual strategies. God wants to redefine your MO, how you operate, how you war a warfare with all the demons surrounding you. Beloved, don't be deceived. It doesn't matter how difficult your stuff is. Remember, we are all going through major battles in our lives. That's the path of the kingdom. The Bible says that those that live godly, in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. He says, you haven't really seen anything until you start doing things right. That's when persecution really comes. These are demons motivating people to attack you. So you cannot use their weapons against them. It will not work. Our weapons, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 4 through 6, once again, our weapons are not carnal, but they are mighty through God. I don't know if you're hearing what I'm saying, beloved, to you this morning. Think about what will engage the might of God, the power of God. Think about hooking up with omnipotence. We will all rush to use the right weapons and stop using these weak ones we've been using all these years. Marking time, wasting time, judging, criticizing, doubting, fearing, jealousies. Rejection. Come on. None of those things will engage God. Hey, God gave me a book called Wisdom in a Bite. Get a copy for $10. God will bless you. There's a quote in that book. It says, angels don't come to pity parties. When you are in a funk, no, you need to get up out of the funk and begin to worship God. You see, you can comfort yourself in your, downness or whatever you call it. You may be distraught, you may be discouraged, and you just mire in it and soak in it and sulk in it. God won't show up. He won't even come. But if you get up and begin to give him the sacrifice of praise, you will engage the Holy Ghost, and the power of God will come rushing in where you are. It takes discipline. It takes faith. But think about the exciting possibility that God will show up for you because you are using weapons that will cause him to get up. Remember the word of the Lord, Psalm 68. Let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let God arise. Yes, beloved, he will not arise if you're using fleshly weapons. He uses simple weapons, spiritual weapons, weapons of humility, weapons of power. Think about it. How can David kill Goliath with a pebble? How can Moses bring Egypt down with a stick? Think of it, beloved. They engaged world powers with a stick, because God said to use it. Just find what he wants to use. You will see him get up. Most times, you are so mired in the hurt and the disappointment and the rejection that you forget that's not your destiny. And God comes along and says, do you want to be blessed? You should shout, yes. Forget about the issue. Get the blessing and move on. The blessing will cause you to forget the issue. God will bless your socks off, and he will give you, as the Bible declares, double for your trouble. But make sure you're using the weapons that will cause him to get up. He said they are mighty through God, and they will pull down strongholds. They will bring down imaginations. They will, every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Isn't that an exciting proposition, beloved? You go to work today with a different perspective. You go knowing that God has equipped you and retooled you. So there will be miracles in your path because he's handing you simple answers. Give that man a smile. Hey, treat that one to lunch. Write a thank you note to that one. Simple weapons. So long as it's coming from him, he will show up. I'm telling you, begin to thank him right now for the solutions of today's victory. Mighty weapons, yet in and of themselves, so simple, so insignificant. But yet, if that's what God wants to use, he will get it done. That's all you care about. Anyway, I want you to understand this week. And then we'll get deeper into our study to show you the mysteries that God has taught us. We love you. Let's conclude tomorrow. That's